right? Because along with that first day of the week doctrine comes this man here. Who is this, might I add? Who is this to you? Who have you been taught that this is?
I wasn't taught about him.
Well, let's look at this photo here. Uh-huh. Who is this photo to you?
Supposed to be Jesus.
That's supposed to be Jesus. Do you pray to this man at night? When you send out prayers, are you envisioning this man in your mind?
I just pray to Jesus.
Okay, but you
said Jesus is a Gentile.
No, Jesus isn't a Gentile. We'll get that for you as well. They say that we were the Gentiles. Even that is a fallacy. Even that is incorrect. We are not the Gentiles. We are the Israelites.
Hey,
all right.
Right.
All right. All right.
Well, to me, I always thought Jesus could be anybody, black, white.
Yeah, and that's what comes along with that Sunday doctrine. All people can be saved. God looks like everybody. All of that, but all of that is fallacy. When in the Bible, you would not find this image right here. This image is not in the Bible. What we're going to do, we're going to shift gears. And we're going to show you the correct image of your Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ.
That's right.
All right. We're going to show you what Christ looks like. All right. But first, you said that Christ was a Gentile. Give me all Hebrews 7 and 14. Watch this. We're going to show you what tribe Christ was from. All right. And if you have any questions, please ask us. We'll be glad to answer those questions for you. Anything that you've been taught in the church and you might have questions about, now's the time to bring it out. You ready?
The book of Hebrews, chapter 7, verse 14. For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
All right, so the Bible said it is evident that our Lord, there's evidence in the Bible that our Lord sprang out of the tribe of Judah.
Yes, right?
All right, so what I want you to do is look at this sign, sis. Where do you see yourself at? Look down this side first. This is what we're called in America, but this is the names that God called us.
Right.
So where do you see yourself on this side? Look right here. I'm going to help you out. Right. So in America, we're called African American or black. But according to the Bible, we are the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
Right? Read that one more time. Listen, let me show you what tribe Christ came from. You are of the tribe of Judah, which means that you are a real Jew.
Right.
Right? You're the real Jew, not a Gentile. You're the real Jew.
That's right.
And we can prove that with the Bible. So listen up. Let's find out what tribe Christ came from again, and then we're going to get his phenotypes to show you exactly what Christ looks like, all right?
Read it out. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 14.
Read it out.
For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
It is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, which today are the so-called blacks or African American.
Right.
Christ, if he walked the earth today, would be a so-called black man.
Right.
All right, now we're going to get the proof and show you this out of the Bible. I know you already know, but your pastor doesn't read this to you, so we're going to bring it out. Watch this.
Revelations chapter 1, verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
So this is the revealing of Jesus Christ. The word revelation means to reveal. The first four letters in Revelations are R-E-V-E-L, reveal. So we are revealing today what Christ looks like, all right? Read.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Now, you standing in front of me, your head is white and it is woolly.
That's right. That's
you understand?
Right. That's right.
This is how we know what tribe Christ came from. When you look at the phenotype of the black man, it says that Christ had hair that was white and woolly.
Teach.
Right? So, follow me. When we look at this image, this is the image that grandma, great-grandma, grandpa, mom, and daddy got in their house. And this is what the Christian church pushes as the image of Christ. And they will have you to believe that this is your Lord and Savior. But when you read the scripture, it said his head and his hairs, meaning the hairs on his head and his beard, were white like wool.
Christ, right? Make it plain.
Is this woolly hair? That's not woolly hair at all. So that's one X for this person that has been set up all over the world as the Messiah.
That's it.
All right?
That's right.
Read.
As white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So the Bible says that Christ's eyes, the whites of his eyes, were as the flame of a fire. Why was Christ's eyes like a flame of fire? You have any idea? What was Christ's first miracle?
When he healed the fat man, I was
his
eyes, right?
Not that one. What was the first miracle? He turned water
into wine.
He turned water into wine, right? Now read this, Genesis 49. Watch this.
Genesis chapter 49, verse 12.
Bring it out.
His eyes shall be red with wine.
So we're reading about Christ. It said his eyes shall be red with wine. When you look at this image right here, are his eyes red? What color are they? They green, blue, and they're still white. There's another X for that image that has been set up all over America as the image of Christ, your Lord and Savior, the Messiah, which is wrong. Read on. We're going to make it plain to you what Christ looked like. Watch this.
Revelations chapter 1, verse 15.
Read out.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
So when we look at our feet, our feet and our face are almost the same color. They may be a little bit lighter because of less sunlight. But it said his feet was like what?
Like unto fine brass.
So now we got an image in the head of feet. And it said his feet like unto fine brass. What color is brass?
Kind of brownish looking.
The sister said brass is brown.
That's
She's correct.
Right. That's right.
Brown. So off gate, it said that he had his hair was white and woolly. His eyes was red like a flame of fire, and his feet were the color of fine brass. And the sister said brown. But watch this. We're gonna bring it home for you. Listen. As if they burned in a furnace. If you burn anything, what color does it turn? Black.
Right.
So we're describing Christ in the Bible.
That's right.
Christ is a black man.
That's right.
But why isn't this being taught in your Christian church? What's wrong with the Christian church? Right? Are they set up for monetary gain? Go to Ezekiel 22. Let me show you something. 22 and verse 26. Watch this. We're going to give you a synopsis of what the Christian church likes to do. They don't teach truth. They don't teach God laws.
Right.
They stray away from God laws. You can do everything. I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthened me, except keep the commandments.
That's right. Bring it up and make it point.
You understand? Watch this. What you got?
Ezekiel chapter 22, verse 26. Her priests have violated my law.
So the Bible says that the church have violated God's laws. They don't teach to keep the Sabbath. They say every day is God's day. Every day is holy. Right? But the Bible says the seventh day is holy and has been separated, and there's things that you can and cannot do.
Right.
We're going to go back to it and make sure you understand. But the priests that are set up, no word tabernacle, no showers of blessings.
That's right.
What are all these other churches around here that don't teach the word of God?
Right.
They set up to take your money. Watch this. Read.
And have profaned mine holy thing.
What did the Bible say? That the church have profaned the holy thing. They don't put no difference between we're going to stick with the Sabbath or any other day. The Most High God esteems one day from another. Understand? Not the white man.
Right.
Not those that be in power.
Right.
As a people, we follow everything that the white man puts in front of us.
That's right.
Even the image of Christ, which is not Christ. We just showed you that Christ was a black man that looks like these brothers out here.
That's right.
All right? Read.
They have put no difference between the holy and profane.
Read.
Neither have they showed difference between the unclean and the clean.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.